Hi, Art here, and welcome back to Stem Cell Talks. Today, we're going to talk about CRISPR. Now, CRISPR's been in the news quite a bit lately, and some of you may know about it. Some of you may have heard little snippets of info, pun intended, in news casts and news feeds. But basically, what CRISPR is, it's a powerful molecular tool for editing DNA. Now, from our biology classes, DNA is nature's instruction manual of life. And that pertains to all organisms, from single cell organisms all the way up to complex organisms like ourselves. So it's the reason why I have blue eyes. It's also the reason why I'm devilishly handsome. Now that's not me talking, that's my wife. My wife says that I'm devilishly handsome, and my wife doesn't lie to me, so I'm assuming it's true. So basically, CRISPR gives researchers a precise and cost-effective way to edit DNA. And with the ability to edit DNA, that opens the door to treat or reverse disease and genetic disorders. Diseases like muscular dystrophy or cystic fibrosis or diabetes or sickle cell anemia. And the way it works is I'm going to give you the simplified version. Basically, researchers have to identify the gene or combination of genes responsible for an affliction. Not an easy thing to do, but once they lock in on the genes responsible for an affliction, they can, with CRISPR, go in and snip that gene out and replace it with a proper gene so that you no longer have the genetic disorder. One might ask what the connection with CRISPR is to stem cells. Basically, if you think about it, we have trillions of cells in our body. And if you wanted to use CRISPR, it would be very difficult to go in and replace defective genes in our body in vivo, meaning in the body. So what you can do, if we remember about stem cells are the only cells that can regenerate. So what researchers do is they take stem cells and they correct the gene in the stem cell. And then they take these corrected stem cells and then they grow them out, they cultivate them into billions of cells, which makes them clinically relevant and useful for treatment. That's another reason why it makes sense to bank your stem cells. If you recall, with stem cells, the younger they are, the better. Younger stem cells are more plentiful, they're more proliferative, they're more active, and they've suffered less environmental degradation. So by banking your stem cells when you're young, you will have them available for these emerging treatments that are going to be relying on CRISPR should you need them. That's it for now. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you again soon.